Once again, welcome to Greene County Tech, home of the Golden Eagles. It's just about time for some Thursday night junior high football action. We welcome in the Brookland Bearcats tonight from just down the road and over the county line into Craighead County. Officials for tonight's game will be the back judge, Michael Harrell, linesman, Eddie Price, umpire, Tony Davis, line judge, Ryan Jones, and referee, Brad Davidson. Looks like captains are heading towards midfield with the umpires. For Brookland will be number 7, Andy Ladd. Number 71, Hudson Owens. And number 14, Davis Holdrove. For the Golden Eagles, it is number 33, Aston Addison. Number 11, Gavin Cup. Number 10, Lane Compton. Back it up on the sideline, that's Sid Palmer. And number 66 down there is Lane Clayton. Bearcats won the toss for first and second half. Golden Eagles elect to receive the football. Bearcats will be defending the north end zone. That's the one down there by the hill. All right, ladies and gentlemen, all you green and gold Golden Eagle fans, it's about that time to get up and get good and loud. Because your Golden Eagles are about to take the field. If you cast your eyes down to the end zone where the cheerleaders and dance team have formed a victory tunnel. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to get good luck. Here comes your Golden Eagles. Receiving team is on the field. Back there is number one, Kyler Willis. I believe that's number 15 back here, Kason Williams. Also out there right now is number 34, Brett Boone. Number 8 out there, Benton Farmer. Bearcat kicking team is on the field. Looks like number 48 didn't kick with him. That's Caden Rodriguez. And that's where the Golden Eagles kick off tonight's football action on offense. Golden Eagle offense right now being led by number 4, Luke Kinsella. Also out there, number 11, Gavin Cup. Takes several big steps, hands down the sideline. He's taking out about number 44, Braxton Good. He'll pick up about 9, making second down at a yard for Greene County Tech. Malachi Clifton handling the snap for the Golden Eagles. Aston Addison on the carry for the Golden Eagle. He'll be brought down by several of the Bearcats, led by, I believe, by number 16 that time. Nick Bates, number 73. Jaden McCaskill. By the way, that's enough for a golden eagle. Down by several of the Bearcats, led by number 40, I believe that was 44, Braxton Good. Also out there with Luke Kinsella, a little bit of a keeper, heads up the middle behind that big offensive line. He'll pick up a couple, make it third down at about five. Number 34 on the tackle, that's Greg Higgins for the Bearcats. Ball will be spotted back near the 37-yard line, 38-yard line. It'll be fourth down and long. Short for the Golden Eagles. It'll be Bearcat ball first and 10. Golden Eagle defense hustling out, being led by number 64, Evan Pretty. Also number 60, Gavin Harris. Also out there is number 8, Benton Farmer. Number 3, Andrew Wagner. Number 5 on the carry, Ethan Clark. He's brought down by number 34, Brent Boone, and number 50, Luke Woods. He'll be second down to about 5 for the Bearcats. Also out there on the Golden Eagle defense, number 16, Aiden Collins. Number 12, Elijah Hammond, the ball carrier, brought down by number 50, Luke Woods. There's a flag on the play back near the line of scrimmage. Holding the ball against the Bearcat offense, backing up 10, remains second down. Now ball is from the 32-yard line. Be second down at about 15. Pass intended for number 14, Davis Polgrove, incomplete. Make it third down at 15. Ball at the Brookland 32-yard line. Over here on the near side on the secondary, number six, Caden Dermott. Excuse me, Caden McDermott. Defense score. Going offense heads out to go for the conversion. Over here on the near side, number one, Kyler Willis. Also out there, number five, Sid Palmer. Luke Consilla getting the plays. Number 66, Lane Clayton out there on the line. So the Golden Eagle kicking team hustles out. They love the number 15 out there, Kaysen Williams. Ben Farmer out there for defense. High kicks for the dance team. Cheerleaders now doing a pyramid thing. It's pretty difficult there, bro. They get to 100, I'll go down there and they can pick me up on the pyramid. Golden Eagle kicking team heading out there. Be number 10, Lane Johnson, handling the kicking charge. Number 16, Nick Bates, recovers the kick by Compton of the Golden Eagle. Ball will be spotted back at the 19-yard line, looks like, with the Bearcats having first and 10. Golden Eagle defense hustling out, getting ready to meet the Bearcats. Clay Kersey heading out there for Golden Eagle. Also out there, number 78, Connor Reiser. Ethan Clark with a carry, and I believe he's brought down by number 54, Clay Kersey of the Golden Eagles. Looks like it'll be right back at the line of scrimmage. Maybe just a tad bit farther back. Second down and a long 10. Thank you. Pass complete to number two, Ethan Bales. I believe he's brought down with number 16, Aiden Collins. Going to move to the six with that one. Ball spotted at the 30-yard line. Just under 2 minutes to go in the first quarter. Encroachment to call against the Golden Eagle defense. Move forward five and remain first down. Jerry brought down with number 54, Clay Kersey. He picked up just a touch. It'll make it second down and about 4 3/4. And Coach McCall on the Golden Eagle defense once again. It'll be a first down for the Bearcats. Gary once again picks up about six. He's brought down by Clay Kersey and also number 16, Aiden Collins. It'll be second down and six. That'll take you to the end of the first quarter. Once again, we'll remind everyone about tomorrow night, game time, 7 o'clock. Come on out a little early. Get a little loud as the Golden Eagles welcome in the El Dorado Wildcats. First time ever here at Golden Eagles Stadium. Little 6A East Conference action. Hope everybody plans to show up tomorrow night. Support our senior Golden Eagles. Certainly want to appreciate all of our aquatic engineers and angels down there helping keep the team hydrated tonight. Appreciate the dance team being here tonight and the cheerleaders. Always happy to see them here. Doing a fantastic job keeping the crowd involved. Let's get Golden Eagle defense out there, number 10, Lane Compton. Even Clark, the ball carrier, brought down by several Golden Eagles that time. Luke Woods in on the tackle. Also, I believe Clay Kersey on that and Lane Compton. Short gain on the play, making third down at about four. Time out. Time out, Bearcats. I want to talk about it. 7:14 left to go in the first half. We'll remind everyone, halftime will be coming up shortly. Hopefully, we'll have a big halftime show for the dance team and the cheerleader. Also, want to remind you, the concession stand is open. If you feel a little snacky snack time or a little drink coming up, head on down there to the concession stand. Support the band tonight. Remember, Tuesday night at the high school arena is senior high girls volleyball, junior high girls volleyball, seventh grade volleyball. We welcome in the Lady Rams apparel to that big cross-town rivalry. Hope everyone shows up and supports the Lady Eagle volleyball team. I believe it's neon night, so pick out your wildest neon colors and wear them up. It's also Teacher Appreciation Night, one of my favorite nights of the year. Hope everyone shows up and supports the Lady Eagle volleyball team this coming Tuesday. Game starts at 4:30 and go most of the night, folks. Come on out. Come out and watch the Rail Rumblers on Tuesday night. Only the defense out there, number 78, Connor Reisner. Number 12, Elijah Hammond, on a little bit of a sweep, runs into about, I'll say, 90.9% of the Golden Eagle defense. So it'll be fourth down at about 6, we'll call it. Looks like they're going to head into punting formation for the Bearcats, and it's number 71, Hudson Owens, back to do the duty. A flag on the play. Sideline warning issued. Andrew Regner returns the ball back to near the 42-yard line for the Golden Eagles to take over first and 10. Luke Gonzalo getting the play call. That's it. On the carry for the Golden Eagle. Picks up Saddle Knife downfield block. One by number 11, Gavin Cup. We pick up about 6, make it 2nd down and 4. He was brought down that time, but number. This might have number 35, Max Wilcoxon. Consella on the carry for the Golden Eagles. Takes out across the 50 to the 48. Gets a little bit past. But that's enough for another Golden Eagle. Looks like the ball spotted right at the 47-yard line. First and 10 for the Golden Eagles. Once again, Malachi Clifton out there handling the center job. Ashton Addison on the carry for the Golden Eagles. He'll pick up 2 yard yards. He's brought down by several of the Bearcats. Number 44 initially. That is Braxton Good. Number 15 on the game for the Golden Eagles, Kaysen Williams. He picks up about four. Maybe that, we'll call it four. Brought down, I believe, at number 11, Tyler Sharp of the Bearcats. Williams on the carry once again for the Golden Eagles. Crosses the 35 down to near the 37-yard line. And that's going to be enough for the Golden Eagle. Gazelle's pass in for number 3, Wagner. Just a bit long. 2:45 left to go in the first half. Second and 10 for Greene County Tech. Luke Gonzalez on the keeper right up the middle, crosses the 30 down to about the 29-yard line. Looks like he'll make it third down and about 6 for Greene County Tech. I believe that tackle was number 48 that time. Caden Rodriguez. Pass falls incomplete for Greene County Tech. Fourth down and about 6. Time out. Golden Eagles. They want to talk about it. Once again, we want to thank the good folks down there handing out the water, the young ladies down there, the aquatic angels. They're doing a fantastic job for us, keeping the boys hydrated. Looks like we've got one aquatic engineer down there as well. Pass complete to number 10, Lane Compton. Ball's going to be spotted inside the 5 near the 3 or 4 yard line. And that's going to be enough for another Golden Eagle. First and goal for Greene County Tech. Timeout. Golden Eagles, once again tomorrow night, game time 7 o'clock. Come out a little bit early and get ready for some high school football action as we welcome in the El Dorado Wildcats. First time ever here at Greene County Tech. So first and goal for Greene County Tech. Ball spotted on the Brookland 3-yard line. Signal caller Luke Kinsella brings the offense through the line. Block up front there, folks, by number 67, Malachi Quinton. Several other nice blocks thrown on that play. Going offense to go out and try to pick up the conversion. Folks, how about the dance team doing those high kicks and the cheerleaders doing their pyramid? It looks like number 10, Lane Thompson, going to do the kicking for the Golden Eagles right here on the near side. Number 15, Casey Williams. Also out there, number 25, Keaton Lyre. Brought down by number 10, Lane Thompson, and number 34, Brent Boone of the Golden Eagles. Minute three left to go in the first half. Bearcats have the ball, first and 10. Spotted at their own 39-yard line. Golden Eagle defense, look out to make a stop in the second half, in the first half. Blueberry brought down by number 3, Andrew Wagner, to go a little bit first down to the Bearcats. Ball spotted right at midfield. Clock is ticking, about 36 seconds left in the first half. Pass complete to number 14, that is Colesgrove. He's brought down to number 10, Lane Thompson. Second down and a long 7, what we're going to call it. Out there right now for the Golden Eagle defense. believe that's number 11, Gavin Cup. Timeout, Bearcats. Number 2, Ethan Bales on the carry. Tackle made by several of the Golden Eagles, including number 50, excuse me, number 64, Evan Whitty. He'll be third down at about 3 for the Bearcats with 17.4 left to go on the clock in the first half. On the clock in the first half. Golden Eagle defense heading out. Big number 64, Evan Twitty out there. Number 50, Luke Woods out there. Number 2, Bales on the carry. He's brought down by number 50, Luke Woods, and number 10, Lane Compton. Fourth down and 5. 10.5 seconds left on the clock. Timeout, Bearcats. Brookland, how you doing tonight? Doing all right tonight? Informed there's going to be a fantastic halftime extravaganza night featuring the junior high dance team and the cheerleaders. So buckle up and get ready for that, folks. It's 10.5 left on the clock, fourth down and 5. So if it's fourth and 5, it's fourth and long time, Golden Eagle fans. So the quick kick by the Bearcats puts the ball first and 10 for the Golden Eagles with 1.8 on the clock. Ball's going to be spotted at the Golden Eagle 37-yard line, and the Golden Eagle offense hustles out. Clay Kersey heading out that way. Also out there, number 66, Lane Clayton heading out. Luke Kinsella calling the play. Clock starts when the whistle blows, folks. That'll take us to the end of the first half with Golden Eagles leading it 16-0 over the Brookland Bearcats. So we're going to put 10 minutes up on the halftime clock. We're going to have the dance team getting ready out there. Ladies and gentlemen, you'll cast your eyes towards midfield. You'll see the junior high dance team getting ready to perform. Junior High Go Legal cheerleaders are making their way out there, folks. Once again, great job there by the dance team. What's going to do? Folks, we're going to take a couple of seconds here and recognize some of those names along the fence and on the far side and down the sideline. If you head by any of our sponsors' businesses, please thank them for being a Go Legal athletic sponsor, like Mayhem Construction, Spencer Tire, Allen Engineering. If you work one of those places, head by their office and tell them thank you from Greene County Tech for helping support out Simmons Bank and First Choice. And who else is over there? Let me get my authors out so I can see a few more. Ridge City Church, we certainly always appreciate it when the churches help out. Printers Inc. and Brown's Chapel Church is over there. Bad Boy Mowers. Or if they'd like to do a demo, my yard's available. OPC, appreciate them. And Sundown. Who else is on that far side over there? Elite Senior Care. I'll probably need them before too long. Lance Beasley Construction and Empower Internet Service. Southern Roots. Like I say, folks, if you go by one of these businesses that's on the fence or on the sideline here, thank you for being a Greene County Tech sponsor.
inside my bones. It goes electric, baby, when I turn it on. Off to my city, off to my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in my zone. I got sunshine in my pocket. I get so on my feet. I feel that God in my body. It drops. Ooh, I can take my eyes off of it. It's so phenomenal. Go on, go ahead and rock it. Don't stop. Under the lights, when everything's rolling. Nowhere to hide when it gets in your clothes.
Spotlight, soundbite, everybody who gave up.
It's just a beautiful morning and more than anybody against us. You can take it, say we're getting hard now. Cause we'll be screaming out, we can be.
Looks like we're just about heading back to second half action here at Golden Eagle Stadium. Want to make a special announcement. On Monday, February 26, 2024, that'll be the grand opening of the girls softball stadium out at the high school. They'll be taking on the Rivercrest Lady Colts at 4:30. Once again, mark your calendars right now, Monday, February 26, 2024, the opening of the new softball stadium for the Lady Eagles. Back deep for the Bearcats receiving team, I believe that's number one, Jaden Parnell. Looks like number 10, Lane Compton, handling the kickoff tonight. Right here on the near side, number 35 for the Golden Eagles, Ryan Floyd. Aiden Collins, I believe, on the tackle there for the Golden Eagles. Ball will be spotted out near the 42-yard line. Bearcat ball first and 10. Golden Eagle defense heading out there. Number 34, Brent Boone, anchoring out there. He'll be the team of the Golden Eagle defense tonight, folks. Number 5 of the ball here, Ethan Clark, brought down with number 10, Lane Compton, also number 50, Luke Woods. Gain of about 2 to make it 2nd down and 8 for the Bearcats. Also out there right now for the Golden Eagle defense, number 3, Andrew Wagner. Number 12, Elijah Hammond, on a little bit of a keeper, picks up a couple. He's brought down by number 10, Lane Compton, number 34, Brett Boone, making 3rd down and about 6, looks like. Pass lead to number two, Ethan Bales. He's brought down almost immediately by number three, Andrew Wagner. The Golden Eagles gain of about two, making fourth down, and we'll call it a long three. So if it's fourth and three, it's fourth and live then. Exhibit number 35 of the Bearcats, Max Wilcoxon, falls incomplete. It'll be first and 10 for the Golden Eagles as the defense forces another turnover on downs. Luke Kinsella rounding up the offense, getting it set up out there. He's the play caller tonight. Clay Kersey out there on that offensive line, along with number 66, Lane Clayton. Also, Malachi Clifton right there in the middle. Pass completion number three, Andrew Wagner. He puts up a goal to you. He's brought down to number 16, Nick Bates. Ball will be spotted down inside the. Around the 9-yard line, folks, in case you don't know, that's enough for a Golden Eagle. So it'll be first and goal for the Golden Eagle. Ball, just like I said, down around the 9-yard line. Kinsella calling the play. Luke Kinsella on the carry, picks up about 8 yards, looks like. It's going to be a second down and goal from the one. A really nice tackle there by the Bearcat defense. I believe number 49 was in on that tackle. Gunner Pulliam. Once again, the offensive line out there being anchored by number 67, Malachi Clifton, number 54, Clay Kersey. Passing ass on the carry for the Golden Eagles. He's brought down by, I believe that's number 34, Drake Higgins. It'll be third down and about, looks like third down and just about six. Excuse me, third down and goal from the six. Folks, if you want to see a textbook pancake box, check out number 66 on the replay, Lane Clayton. All right, folks, we're getting ready for that two-point conversion. The cheerleaders and dance team are getting ready to do their... So that'll take us to 4:02 left in the third quarter. Golden Eagles leading 24-0 over the Bearcats. Lane Compton down there to do the kicking tour for the Golden Eagles this time. Back deep for the Bearcats, number one, Jaden Parnell. On the far side of the field for the Golden Eagles kicking team is number 15, Casey Williams. Also out there, number 11, Gavin Cup. Return number three, Chris Long of the Bearcats. Brought down by Sam with Golden Eagles. I believe Brett Boone is on that tackle. Also think number 16 is on that tackle, Aiden Collins. The first down and 10, ball spot at the 41-yard line. Golden Eagle defense comes to the line. Anchored out there right now with number 64, Evan Twitty. Number 5, Ethan Clark, the ball carrier. He's brought down by number 78, Connor Reisner. Number 34, Brett Boone. Gain of about 5. I will call it 4. Second down and 6. The ball carry once again. He's brought down by number 10, Lane Compton. Number 54, Cody Kersey. Third down at about a yard for the Bearcats. On the far side over there, Sid Palmer for the Golden Eagles. Number 12, Ethan Hammond on the carry. He's thrown for a loss, but number 10, Ray Thompson will go with it. Takes it all the way back near the 45-yard line, so that'll make it fourth down there about 6. Go with the defense. Looking to make another turnover on downs. Delay a game called against the Bearcats. That'll back it up 5. Remains fourth down. So it'll now be fourth down in 11 for the Bearcats. Snap. Recovery for number 71 of the Bearcats. That is Hudson Owens. So it'll be tech ball deep in Bearcat territory. Looks like it'll be first and goal from around the 9-yard line for the Golden Eagle offense. Luke Kinsella getting the play call. Zane Case out there on the offensive line right now, folks. Touchdown! Golden Eagles! Ashton Addison on the carry from Greene County Tech with a 9-yard score. Thank you. Golden Eagle offense comes up just a tad bit short. Couple of McCallum out there, he's getting good and loud.
7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17.
Going to be heading out there, Lane Thompson, do the chore. Also heading out there on the kicking team is number 32, Johnny Alger. Back deep for the Bearcats, number 1, Jaden Parnell. Come on, folks, step out of them high kicks. That's 30 high kicks. That's a ton on the night for them. Number 19 on the return, Will Reeves. He's brought down by number 56, Zane Cates of the Golden Eagles. Balls will be spotted near the 46-yard line, first and 10 for the Bearcats. Tennessee got their high kicks in on the 30. I think that's a little bit over 100 high kicks for them tonight. Number 5, Clark the carrier. He's brought down by number 16, Aiden Collins. He'll bring up about 5 where Collins brings it down. In the closing minutes of the closing seconds of the third quarter. Jaden Parnell on the carry for the Bearcats, brought down by number 16, Aiden Collins, number 50, Luke Woods. That'll take us to the fourth quarter, folks. It'll be a first down for the Bearcats when play resumes. Once again, let me remind you about tomorrow night, game time, 7 o'clock. Welcome in the Eldorado Wildcats. GCT Golden Eagles. Pretty great that conference victory tomorrow night. Talk to some offensive line as they will be handing out pancakes all night, folks. Come on out tomorrow night for pancake night on Friday night, 7 o'clock game time. Touchdown Bearcats, number 5, Ethan Clark, on the carry. Number 5, Ethan Clark, takes it across the goal line for the 2-point conversion for the Bearcats. Going out, Golden Eagles 30, Bearcats 8. Golden return team looking to head out there. And McBee, number one, Tyler Willis. Also out there, number 25, Keaton Lyerly. Number 32 is out there, Johnny Alger. Right in the middle, but number 64, Evan Twitty. Kicking off for the Bearcats will be number 48, Caden Rodriguez. Onside kick is in for cover number three, Andrew Wagner of the Golden Eagles. It'll be first and 10, Greene County Tech. Ball spotted at their own 48-yard line. Luke Kinsella got the play call. Ashton Addison on the carry for the Golden Eagles gets behind the block on number 54, Clay Kearney. He'll pick up about 8 big yards there, maybe 9, brought down by several of the Bearcats. Number 16, Nick Bateson on that tackle. Also number 11, Tyler Sharp. So it'll be second down and a long yard, maybe 2, for the Golden Eagles. Ashton Addison on the carry once again for the Golden Eagles. Nice block cover, Gavin Cup. Ball's been spotted up near the 38-yard line. And that's going to be enough for a Golden Eagle. Williams on a carry for the Golden Eagles, picks up several big yards, taken down on the far side of the field by, I believe that was number 11 of the Bearcats, Tyler Sharp. It'll be second down and a long 4 for Greene County Tech. Like I say, ball spotted at the 32-yard line, need to get to the 28-yard line. Jason Williams on the carry for the Golden Eagles. Takes it out near the 26-yard line. That's going to be enough for a Golden Eagle. Hi, Mitchell. How are you doing tonight? Doing all right? Oh, Ashton Addison on the carry. So the Golden Eagles put another 8 on the board. It'll be 38-8 right now over the Bearcats. The Golden Eagles team being running out. Always hustling. That's the Golden Eagle way. Lane Thompson. Handling the kick and score tonight. Gavin Cup hustling out there on the far side, heading over number 15, Casey Williams. Also out there, number 8, Benton Farmer. Number 16 on the return, Nick Bates. He's brought down by number 19, Ross Dennis, and number 25, Keith Lyerly. Ball's been spotted just about the 49-yard line of the Bearcats, first and 10. 4:37 left to go in the contest. Mark the ball game, brought down by number 54, Clay Cruzen. This is a nice game there by Ethan Clark. About a 6-yard, 7-yard game, making second down and 3. The ball here brought down by several leaders. Level number 64, Evan Twitty. Also went on that tackle, I believe, number 54, Clay Kersey. And number 10, Lane Thompson. It'll be a first down for the Bearcats. Ball spotted at their own 41-yard line. Just about 3:20 left to go in the contest. Bearcat pass will be number 14, Davis Pongo, will go in for a score. Conversion's hit no good by the Bearcats. Several in that tackle. So the Golden Eagle return team hustles out once again. Brett Boone on his way out there. Also run out there, number 1, Tyler Lewis.
We are the
Keith Lyle out there looks like he's going to be putting up the... Also out there, number 32, Johnny Alder. Number 50, Lee Wood. Number 16, Aiden Collins. Number 11, Gavin Duff. Nice catch while ago, Gavin. Kicking off with the Bearcats, number 48, Caden Rodriguez. Onside attempt recovered by the Golden Eagles. I believe that's number 8, Benton Farmer, on that recovery. Goalie Lopez comes out, takes over first and 10, ball at their own 46-yard line. Once again, number 67, Malachi Clifton out there is the apex point of the Golden Eagle offensive line. Kinsella's pass into number 1, Tyler Willis, an incomplete. Nice defensive coverage there by the Bearcats. I believe that's number 2, Ethan Bales. But number 2, Ethan Bales, there is a late flag on the play. Unsportsmanlike conduct, the call against the Bearcats. That'll march it forward 15 yards and be a first down for Greene County Tech. 2:25 left to go in the game. Ball spotted at the 44-yard line. Action has it on the carry for the Golden Eagles. He's brought down the number 49, Gunner Polium. It'll be second down and 2. Luke Gazella's passing complete to number 5, Sid Palmer. Palmer goes forward for about 6 yards. Ball will be spotted at the 28-yard line, and that's enough for a Golden Eagle. And once again on the carry for the Golden Eagles, picks up some hard yards after initial contact. Comes down to around the 23-yard line. Second down and 5. Several Bearcats in on that tackle, including number 34, Drake Higgins. Just about 30 seconds left on the clock. We have a illegal procedure going against the Golden Eagles. There was a loose ball on the play. Illegal procedure against the Golden Eagles. It'll back up 5 yards. The Eagles retain possession. Second down and 10 for Greene County Tech. Just about 15 seconds left on the clock. Well, thank you, Steve. In the corner, folks. Our final score, Golden Eagles 38, Bearcats 14. Once again, tomorrow night, 7 o'clock game time. Head on out here and support the senior Golden Eagles as they take on the El Dorado Wildcats. Once again, game time, 7 o'clock. Remember, next Tuesday night is Paragool coming over for volleyball at the arena. Game started 4:30, junior high and senior high action. It's also teacher appreciation night. It's neon night for the student section. Come on out, folks, support the Lady Eagle volleyball team. And once again, Greene County Tech would like to thank you all for coming out tonight and supporting both these schools and their fine student athletes. We hope everyone had a good time tonight. Wish you all a safe trip home.
good. How are you doing? Thank you. Thank you.